dodging bullets, watching my back. Underrepresentation, overexposure, indignation, disrespect. Reading newspapers about congressional decisions to deepen my debt. Pastors stayed demanding my repentance. Since I was 4, he knows I have a short life expectancy. Plus, I'm always 3 strikes from a life sentence. Diabetes, high blood pressure, heart attacks, strokes. My home had no backbone. Flexible spine, playing limbo with the poverty line. See, if I lose, I choke. Paranoia, disillusionment, misinformation. Posing as my elementary education. Economic inflation. Uncle Tom role models. Wannabe gangsters. And real gangsters. Watch as I, without a father figure, try to figure fathers who tell their sons, why bother, nigga?
This is what happens when a boy is supposed to be a man at an age where he's too young to understand, to pay his dues, thinking, my father didn't even leave me flip-flops. How am I supposed to fill his shoes? He's told, men don't cry. 18 years never shed a tear, and he never felt more alive than the day he cried. All men cry. I have heard black men crying behind prison walls because slavery was never abolished, just amended, prison intended, and the tenants tended to be Africa's descendants. But they will spin it with percentages and say, blacks do more of the crime. But white-collared criminals get off with minimal sentences, pensions and shit. Hence this is slavery, endlessness. Which one of you is listening? Tell me, how do you reverse 400 years of conditioning? Then I will look you in the eye and tell you, the first step is to cry.
Our young men face a tremendous amount of pain in their life. So they're facing the emotion, they're feeling the emotion. The only question is whether they're gonna express it. And we're saying it's more healing to express it. That there's nothing soft or weak about crying, or about dealing with emotion, or about dealing with pain. That yes, our young men need to be raised to be tough in a certain way. And by tough, I mean able to withstand a lot of the realities that society will throw at them. But tough does not mean showing no emotion, having a mask at all time, not being able to process emotion until you strike out against somebody you love. And so we will be emotional. And that group on the Lower East Side that we started with when they were 15 and 16 years old, they took to it very quickly, and they would greet each other with love. And they would say, I love you, to their fellow brothers.
The Brotherhood has really allowed me to not be afraid to do things that were previously taboo, like let down my guards and shed tears, you know, to hug another man and not say, you know, that shit is gay.
Going through the rites of passage program, that helped me get a better understanding of the bonds and connections that two men can make and show emotion towards one another. So, I mean, going away to these wilderness retreats definitely opened up my eyes.
And it got to a point where, you know, maybe like a year and a half into being part of the rites of passage program, that is the Brotherhood, I would go back to my hood and be like, yo, CIA, man, they brought crack into into the United States. That's bullshit, son. A word? I got it documented right here. Let me break this down to you. Bah, 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 bah. So I became like this pseudo teacher in the hood, you know, being like 16 years old. And dudes who at one point would be like, man, shut the hell up with that. You know, they started to be like, word? Yo, tell me more.
And always just to be like a lover of knowledge more than anything. That's what Jason told us once. And I don't know, Bill Cosby told him was make sure you have a love for knowledge. Always love to learn, you know, have that love to learn. Just helping them realize how beautiful and how powerful they are and their minds are and them seeing their potential and understanding what potential is and how they could just do anything they want, you know, and not allow other people to hold them back.
Yeah. It's rare that you walk into a building and be greeted by every staff member with either a hug or a handshake of some sort, and you just feel like the love in the building. I wrote in a recent college essay about bro sis in particular, and I said when I walk into the building, it feels like I'm in heaven. Black and brown angels are all around me.
To know that I have a young son right now, and just the prospect of him being in a chapter makes me smile, because it could only be better, you know? We can only progress from here. And just being a small part of it, I feel blessed and I feel very fortunate just to be along for the ride, you know? Work.
There's a young woman who's been a part of our program and for a long time. And she said that the power of this organization, Brotherhood, Sister, Soul, is that we don't try to save young people, but we try to provide them with the skills so that they can save themselves.